Welcome to the ET197 Automation Studio Quick Start for Hydraulics. Okay, here we are at our Automation Studio and we're going to build our hydraulic system here. So first thing let's do is start a project. Project. And we're going to use, let's use an ANSI B. Good. Okay, first thing we need to do is go to hydraulic and we're going to need a pump. So pumps and amplifiers and fixed displacement unidirectional, and we're going to get one fixed displacement with a pump and shaft. Good, and we need an engine, so we're going to have to go down here all the way to drive and transmission. Power units. Engine, and we should be able to connect that up like that. Yes. Okay, and we need a hydrostatic reservoir, so let's back up here to hydraulics. And reservoirs, and we need a hydraulic reservoir. Good. Double acting cylinder, so we need to go to, not accumulator, actuators. And we need a double acting cylinder. And this guy here looks good enough. Good. And we need a directional valve. And we need a four two-way valve. And we're going to use, it looks like a manual. So let's go ahead and use this one. And the last thing we need is a pressure relief. So, okay, pressure valves. Let's go to pressure relief valves. Remote relief valves, and I think we'll just use this one right here. And that looks good for now. Okay, so let's close out of our library explorer and let's go to view and let's go ahead and go to window. We'll try this one here. There we are. So let's rearrange these like the schematic shows here on our lab. That's good. Relief valve over here, motor and pump down here, and our reservoir right here. Okay, that looks good for now. So let's go ahead and go home and use our link tool. And it looks like this one is going into there. Let's move him over. There we go. And let's move him over. Connect that. And let's escape out of that. Let's fix our motor here. And this one should go up this connection. Let's move that down a little bit. There we go. And we're gonna, this is going to go back to our reservoir. And let's see if this will, we have to insert a junction. So let's see if that allows us to do that without. And it does. And that looks good. Okay, now that it's built, let's go in and simulate it and see if we get everything hooked up properly. And we could go to simulation, go that way, or we could just go ahead and use the icon on the top. Alrighty, we have pressure. And red is pressure, and blue is return. And right now we have a pump. And this is an incompressible fluid, it's hydraulic, so unlike our pneumatics, which is air, which is compressible, this has to use relief valves. Right now, since this valve is closed, our pump, which is incompressible, so we have to keep pushing it out through our relief valve. So this is a constant flow pump. And right now we're relieved of pressure, so let's go ahead and push our manual switch over, and now we have pressure pushing the cylinder out, and whatever's exhausted goes back to our tank. Okay, and let's release that. Now let's show a cross-section of our pump. So we're going to right-click, go to animation, and push our button, and it extends, retract, extend. So that's good. Okay, let's go ahead and modify this, and we're going to put a load on it and add another cylinder. First thing I wanted us to do is line this up with the valves where this is straight, so that's fine. So let's go ahead and click, right click, we're going to copy and paste. And that looks good. And we're going to make a connection here. So let's go back to link. It looks like this far one's going to go all the way to this side, and this one's going on this side of the cylinder. And that looks good. Okay, we're going to put a load on our second cylinder. So let's go back to our pointer tool here and double click on our. And we want to incline, and we want to incline 40 degrees. Yes, 40 degrees. Alrighty, and we want to put a load on it, external load of 5,000. 5,000 pounds. Okay, that looks good actually. Okay, we're going to rotate our second cylinder in order to make it look like our settings. So we're going to position rotation, click on it. And here we have our center line. And we're just going to grab the end and tilt it up a little bit. That's to make it look like it's. And let's go ahead and push it up a little bit. There we go. Okay, we need to add some measuring instruments. So let's go ahead and open up our Library Explorer. And we're in hydraulics, so we're going to go down to measuring instruments, and we need a pressure gauge. And I think we're going to put it right here. Let's see if it'll latch. Yeah, we'll connect it here in a second. So there's our pressure gauge, and we need a flow control, flow meter. And that one, we're going to have to do some modifications too. Okay, so let's go ahead and link this. Good. Yep, that's good. And this one we want it in, so we're going to have to pointer tool. Let's go ahead and window this and see if we can move it all down. Good. So let's see if we can fit our flow meter in. And not enough. So let's go ahead and move it down a little more. How about we shift and put it in there? There we go. Okay. If it's black, it's good. If it's red, it's no good. So that's looking good for right now. So let's shut out of our, and let's, okay, so let's go ahead and simulate it, but I broke the cardinal rule of design, so we need to save this. So let's go in here, and I'm going to go ahead, and we're going to add some more commands. And we're going to go down to save as, save project as, we're going to add it to our list. Okay, and that way we could save this project into our student drive. There's mine, and I'm going to call it Hydraulic 1. Good. Can't save to this PC. Yes, I can. There we go. Okay, good. So let's try simulation, see if it works. Ooh, yes, we have pressure. And let's go ahead and move it in. Good. So what's happening? This guy is under load. And he's going to be slower than this one who has no load. So let's go ahead and move it over. And he's not going to move until this one's finished. So the pressure's high enough to move him over. And let's see what our GPM is. Okay. And we have a fixed, this is a fixed flow pump. And let's go ahead and adjust this guy. So okay, so it looks like it doesn't do much for our system. So let's go the other direction. Let's go way down and see if it may not even operate. And it won't because we're at the bottom cylinder may work, but not the top one. So let's try it. Bottom cylinder is moving, but there's just not enough pressure to move our second one. So let's kick it up a little bit. So 300 psi will work. Let's go ahead and release it. See if it'll go back up. And it's working now. So we could adjust the pressure of this relief valve in order to drive this other cylinder. So that's looking good. I think we're done.